According to the latest scientific results, maybe it's the absence of matter what created matter and all the universe. But how did space-time singularity come about? And what was before? In today's video, we reveal the latest extraordinary findings and theories and all the consequences it holds for us. Scientists credit the Big Bang for the creation of our universe. This theory suggests that the cosmos began as a space-time singularity about 13.8 billion years ago, before expanding exponentially at extreme temperatures and high density to grow into what it is today. The universe, as described by scientists, is made up of three substances: dark matter, dark energy, and normal matter. And quite possibly, one of these elements, normal matter, would have been around when the Big Bang happened. But matter, as we know it, is made up of atoms and molecules, which did not exist during the creation of the universe and for hundreds of decades afterwards, meaning they couldn't have existed before the Big Bang. So what did? According to scientists, the oldest matter particles to exist are photons and neutrons. Both are believed to have been formed around 10,000ths of a second after the Big Bang. However, some principles of physics allow scientists to probe deeper into what happened during the creation in an attempt to discover which stable matter was formed first. And that investigation has led us to the Grand Unified Epoch. But even that is nothing more than speculative physics, because our inability to reproduce the intense levels of energy and temperature that facilitated the Big Bang has left us guessing and double-guessing what went down on the day and how it happened. One theoretical explanation would be that our universe was formed from the radical combination of basic element particles, such as quarks, which are the building blocks of protons and neutrons. Equal amounts of matter and antimatter were also said to have existed. However, we know both these particles are supposed to cancel themselves out as quickly as they're formed. But based on theories, they would have existed even for a trillionth of a millisecond before they were destroyed. According to quantum field theory, a vacuum, like an empty space-time, contains physical activity in the form of energy fluctuations. These fluctuations can cause particles to appear and disappear within a twinkle of an eye. This seems like mathematical oddity rather than actual physics theory. However, such particles have been observed in several experiments over time. Fast forward to the 20th century, Albert Einstein introduced the theory of relativity, which helped scientists connect the concept of mass and time. Einstein demonstrated that huge objects like our planet create a strong gravitational field that slows down time. For example, the incredible mass of our planet bends time, causing it to flow slower for a person on the surface than for an astronaut in orbit. The difference is quite minimal and can only be measured using atomic clocks. Given that the singularity before the Big Bang had all the mass in the universe, it halted time. Hence, Einstein suggested that there was no sense in predicting what happened before the Big Bang because it would have been impossible for anything to exist before it. But rather than solving the mystery, it created more confusion. The notion that nothing existed before the cosmic singularity is difficult to comprehend. But that's not to say scientists doubt the Big Bang theory. On the contrary, scientific data have actually given more credence to the Big Bang. Like the Hubble constant, aka Hubble-Lemaître law, introduced in 1929, or the cosmic microwave background theory, put forward by Robert Woodrow Wilson and Arno Allan Penzias in 1965. This phenomenon surfaced more than 350,000 years after the Big Bang. But the weird theories and counter-theories about what existed before the Big Bang didn't end there. Back in the 1930s, physicist Erwin Schrödinger introduced an interesting experiment to unravel some of the misconceptions around Copenhagen interpretation of superposition as it applies to quantum theory. In this imaginary experiment, the Nobel Prize winner assumed that if a cat is trapped in a steel box with a hammer and a vial of hydrocyanic acid, that could only be released if the radioactive atom decays. Once a single atom of the radioactive substance is decayed, a chain reaction triggers the hammer to smash the vial of the hydrocyanic acid, which eventually kills the cat. But as we know, radioactivity works based on the quantum principle, which means the cat will eventually die whether the radioactive substance decays or not. This leaves the cat in a superposition in between life and death. Another scientist, Eugene Wigner, attempted to simplify the paradox. He imagined that instead of a cat, a human friend of his is shut in a lab measuring a quantum system. Wigner claims that it would be ridiculous to say his friend is in a superposition like the cat was until the lab door is opened. Commenting on the Wigner's concept, Nora Tischler, a quantum physicist at Griffith University in Brisbane, said, "The Wigner's friend thought experiment shows that things can become very weird if the observer is also observed." Based on this experiment, scientists came to understand that quantum world exists in a state of uncertainty until it's observed. Observation could also be the ordinance of engagement between any two particles. It could also have played a role in what occurred before and during the Big Bang. More recently, we've had other attempts by theorists to explain what was before the Big Bang, using different physics concepts and theories, such as multiverses, containing an infinite number of parallel universes, or cyclical prototypes of the universe that are being born and reborn again. Physicist Roger Penrose proposed a controversial theory called the conformed cyclic cosmology. Penrose's concept was stimulated by his interest in the mathematical connection between a very hot, dense, small state of the universe, as it was at the beginning of creation, and an extremely cold, empty, expanded state of the universe. Another interesting analogy is that maybe the absence of matter is what created all the matter we have in the cosmos today. But how is that possible? Scientists who pioneer this school of thought believe that before the Big Bang, all the existing matter in the universe had been consumed by black holes, meaning that even though they existed, they were technically lost in a void. So based on this theory, matter existed before the Big Bang, but they appeared as nothing because the gravitational pull of the black hole ensured that they were trapped and unable to escape within it. Although it would take some time to prove, some scientists believe that the cosmos is much older than we think, and other universes could have been in existence before ours. Under this theory, scientists predict that the universe is about 1 trillion years old, and instead of being a one-off event, the Big Bang is a cyclic event that occurs repeatedly. "People have inferred that time began then, but there really wasn't any reason for that inference," said Neil Turok, a theoretical physicist at the University of Cambridge. "What we are proposing is very radical. It's saying there was time before the Big Bang."